So I have multiple files and I want to combine data from all those files into one single file. So in this video, we'll understand that how we can use Power Query to actually combine data from multiple files. So let's get started. All right, so here I have a folder on my desktop, and in this folder, I have four files from where I want to combine data. So if I open one file, the first file, it has a data, small set of data with six columns, and there is a name of the worksheet, and then there is a specific name for the table as well. Now the point is, for each file that I have in the folder, the worksheet name and the table name is same. So if I open the South, you can see the worksheet name and the table name here is the same. So the worksheet name and the table name is exactly same in all the files. So I'll go to Data tab, and in Get and Transform Data, I will click on Get Data, and from File, and then from Folder. And here I will select the folder from where I want to combine data, and then I will click OK. Now here it shows me the list of files that I have in the folder, and from here I will click on Combine. So this is the drop down that you need to click. So I will select Combine and Transform Data. It takes a few seconds to open the next dialog box. And here I have the parameter. So as I said, we have the worksheet name same in all the files, and we have table name same in all the files. So it shows me two ways to combine data. One is by using the table name, and the second is by using the worksheet name. So I will go by the worksheet name. I'll click on Sales Sheet and click OK. Again, it takes a few seconds. And here we have a data in the Power Query editor. Now, as you can see, we have exactly same columns: serial number, date, product, price, quantity, and amount. And here we have one more column that is by the file name. So it says source.name, and here we have the name of the file. For each entry, there is a name of the file. Now my data is combined, but I want to make a few changes because I want to use it further in, you know, in some sort of reporting. So I will make a few changes. The first change I will make, I will change the name of this folder. So instead of using the source name, I will go by zone. And the second change that I want to make is to remove this .xlsx. So for this, I'll select the column, go to transform, click on replace values. And in the value to find, I will type XLSX. And for the replace with, I will left it blank because I don't want to replace it with anything. I just want to remove it, and I will click OK. Now the third change that I'm going to make is to remove the serial number column. So I will right click and click remove. Now here you can see all the changes or all the steps that I perform in Power Query are listed here in this applied step. The point what I'm trying to make here is Power Query is real time. So when you do something in Power Query, it stores those steps, and you don't need to do that action again and again. You just need to refresh it, and it will get the updated data for you from the source files. So here I have my data ready, and I will go to the Home tab and click on Load, Close and Load. And the moment I do this, it gives me the entire data into the worksheet. So the point what I was trying to tell you, that Power Query is real time. And to make you understand, I will take a little example. So here in the first entry, we have East, and then we have date, that is 6th of November 2018. And then we have product name, price, quantity, and amount. So I will go to the East file, and I will update this entry. So this is the first entry, and here I will update the price. I will enter 89, and from here I will change the quantity. and I will update the amount as well. So we have new price, that is 89, quantity 45, and amount, the total amount is 4005. And I'll save this file and close it. Alright, so now I'm gonna refresh this table, and you just need to, you know, keep a look on these three columns, and I will right click and click on refresh. And here we have our updated entry, that is 89, 45 and 4005. So this is how you can refresh a Power Query and it will get the updated data from the source files. So you don't need to do the compilation again and again. It's a one-time activity and you can save a lot of time. All right, so let's talk about a different situation, a situation where I don't have same worksheet name in each of the files. So if I open East and if I open North, you can see that the worksheet name is not same in these files. Now in this case, I can still combine data from these files, but I need to use a different approach. I will use Power Query, but I will use it in a different way. Let me go to the data tab, get data from file and then from folder. I'll select the folder and open it. And now here I have the list of the files. And instead of using combine, I will click on transform data. So I have this content column and further I have these binary values. So what I'll do, I'll right click on the content column and go to the remove other columns option. And now I have only one single column. And from here, I need to add a new column using a custom formula. So I'll click on add column and then custom column. And here I will use a formula. Excel dot workbook, and I will refer to the content column. And now I will click OK. All right, so now I have this custom column with table entries, and the data that I want is inside these table entries. So I will click on filter and expand it. Click OK. Now, here you need to understand one thing. There are two ways to get data. The one is through the table and one is through the worksheet. Now here I have double entries for each of the files, East and East one. So first entry shows data through the sheet and the second entry shows data through the table. But I just want to go with the sheet. I don't want to go with the table way. So I will untick the table here. And now again, I have four entries because I have four files in the folder. Now the next thing what I'll do, from the custom data column, I have table entries and the actual data of the worksheet is inside this table entry. So what I'll do, I'll click on the filter button. And you can see here I have six columns. So six columns are exactly from the data that I have in the worksheet. So I'll click OK. And here I have the data from all of these files. Now here I need to do a few tweaks to clear this data to make it usable. So what I'll do, I will first delete the columns that I don't need. And now I need to delete these entries, these heading entries. But first of all, I want to have, you know, these entries as a column header. So for this, I'll go to this option and click on use first row as headers. And now I just need to delete, you know, these three entries, that is for headings. So I will simply filter out and untick and click OK. Now the last thing is to change the name of this column because this is a zone column. So I'll change it and hit enter. Now at this point, my data is ready to use it further in any sort of, you know, reporting or something. And now I'll go to the home tab and click on close and load. So here I have my data, combined data from all the files. Now the next thing is to change the formatting a little bit, because this column has dates. So I need to apply date format here. Let me change it. Yeah. Now we'll update an entry in the source file to see if this, you know, data compilation actually works on the real time. So I'll go to the south and make a change into it. Alright, so it was the first entry of South. So this is the entry which I have updated, and now let me refresh it. So here is the first entry that is just updated from the source file. So the Power Query is the easiest way to get data from multiple files into one single file.